all conventional wisdom would have told you that when you moved down to Miami to avoid the heat that you were getting in Georgia, that you would change your behavior. But Demetrius, he just couldn't help himself. It was almost impossible for Demetrius to keep a low profile. It was like a moth to a flame. Crowbar at the time was one of the hottest clubs in Miami. First week Meech got there, he declared Sunday nights at Crowbar BMF night.
Crowbar staff came to us and asked us if we'd like to promote Sunday night. They would give us 10% of the bar and 100% of the door. That'll also give me a chance to promote the label. The house will be packed every Sunday.
Meech said, I'm out so much in the streets, when am I doing anything else? You know, I'm promoting my record label. It was like a smoke and mirrors kind of thing. But there were so many different people around, that's what made it so hard to know who was actually a federal agent and who was actually a person out just having a good time on the party scene with us. We know they're here. So we're looking over our shoulders every day, every day.
In Miami, Meech's presence alone just spoke for itself, because he gonna stick out wherever he at. He a person that he can't hide. Meech was like spending the money, he having a good time. It was crazy.
Meech said, fuck it, I'm gonna be ballin' till they get me. I accepted my position and what come with it a long time ago. I'm gonna be doing this as big as I can do it until the day I can't do it no more.
Terry didn't like that Meech was a party animal because, you know, it just brought so much attention. It was like a big disagreement.
Doing what we doing, I seen so many people go to prison and graveyard. I believe living every day like the last.
When you're a drug kingpin, you might go out to the club and pop some bottles and buy some jewelry and live the good life. But the stress level, it's stressful, man. Trust me, it's more stressful than running Amazon. You're stressed out every day. Ask Meech, was he ever relaxed? You're always thinking, are the police coming? What's next? Is someone else coming?
Have you ever been in a situation where all the walls are caving in, the ground's sinking and everything? Ain't shit you can do about it, but guess what? You can ride it till the wheels fall off, good and bad.